Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Let's talk about electric power. Remember that power equals the derivative of potential energy with respect to time. Billy, please begin with that equation and derive an equation for electric power.
Absolutely. That means electric power equals the derivative of electric potential energy with respect to time. We know electric potential energy equals charge times electric potential difference. Mr. P, may we assume the electric potential difference is constant?
Yes, Billy. Let's assume the electric potential difference of our circuit element is constant.
Great. That means electric power equals the derivative of charge with respect to time times electric potential difference. And the derivative of charge with respect to time is electric current. That means the rate at which a circuit element converts electric potential energy to heat, light, and sound equals the current through the circuit element multiplied by the electric potential difference across the circuit element.
Yes, Billy, that is correct. Bobby, please use the more common version of Ohm's law to derive another expression for electric power.
Okay, Ohm's law says electric potential difference equals current times resistance. We can substitute that into the expression for electric power Billy derived, and we get that electric power also equals the square of the electric current through a resistor times the resistance of the resistor.
Thank you, Bobby. Bo, there is one more expression for electric power. Please derive that.
Sure. From Ohm's law, we know current equals electric potential difference over resistance. Substitute that into Bobby's equation, and we get that electric power equals the square of electric potential difference over resistance.
Yes, thank you, Bo. We just used Ohm's law to prove electric power equals current times electric potential difference, current squared times resistance, and electric potential difference squared over resistance. Now, let's look at a unit which is often used when it comes to electricity, the kilowatt hour. Bo, please work with the units of 1 kilowatt hour to see if you can ferret out what a kilowatt hour actually is.
Ferret? What does a domesticated polecat kept as a pet or used for catching rabbits have to do with kilowatt hours?
He said to ferret out what a kilowatt hour actually is. It just means to search tenaciously for something. He likes to use weird words like that sometimes.
So do I.
Of course you do. Jinx,
you owe me a soda.
Okay. 1 kilowatt hour. Bo, please?
Sure. 1 kilowatt hour. We know 1 watt equals 1,000 kilowatts. Now we have 1,000 watt hours. A watt is a joule per second. Joule hours per second is just weird. So, we know 3,600 seconds is the same as 1 hour. That means 1 kilowatt hour is the same as 3.6 megajoules? Really?
Yep. The kilowatt hour is another misnomer, an inaccurate name or designation. Kilowatt hour sounds like it is a unit of power. However, it is actually a unit of energy.
Words.
Yeah.
But is it really a misnomer? I mean, it does say kilowatt hour, so it clearly is not just a unit of power. It's pretty clear something else is going on.
Huh. I think we tend to just hear the kilowatt and immediately think it has to do with power.
Okay, that makes sense. I guess none of the terms in kilowatt hour initially seem to have anything to do with energy.
Except that watts are joules per second.
Yeah. Maybe not a misnomer? Perhaps kilowatt hour is just misleading.
Yeah, maybe.
All right, so a light bulb is a common item used in physics. A light bulb can be treated as a resistor which converts electric potential energy to light, heat, and sound energy. And the brightness of a light bulb increases with increasing power and decreases with decreasing power. Therefore, the brightness of a light bulb is often used to demonstrate the power in an electric circuit. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.